On May 6, 2022, a swarm of earthquakes began to the northwest of the city of Grindavik in Iceland. These quakes were not tectonic in origin, but rather occurred due to the movement of magma. Over the next 11 days, more than 3,300 earthquakes occurred, the largest of which is a magnitude 4.3. This occurred alongside magmatic uplift over dozens of square kilometers. As a result, the alert level of the Reykjanes Volcano, which spans several hundred square kilometers of ground, was raised from green to yellow on May 15th. As displayed by this map, courtesy of the Iceland Met Office, the ground uplift is centered 2.5 kilometers north-northwest of the city of Grindavik. The ongoing intrusion of magma is currently at between 3 and 5 kilometers depth with a volume of approximately 1.5 million cubic meters. While this may sound like a lot of material, as it could fill 6,000 Olympic-sized swimming pools, this is rather small for a magmatic intrusion. Although there isn't a strong correlation, generally speaking, the smaller an intrusion of magma is, the less likely it is to reach the surface. Regardless of its small size, this magmatic intrusion is quite interesting for a number of reasons. For context, the Reykjanes Peninsula consists of four separate poorly defined volcanic systems. While these systems can individually erupt, they tend to erupt in relatively rapid succession during a period of prolonged elevated volcanic activity. The last such period of elevated activity on the peninsula resulted in a series of 18 eruptions between 840 and 1240 AD. The reason I am bringing this up is when Geldingadal erupted in early 2021, many scientists said that we were at the beginning of a several decade to several century long period of intensified volcanic activity on the peninsula. I agree with this assessment, but think the unrest truly began in early 2020. That year, the alert level of the Reykjanes volcano was also raised to yellow on two separate occasions as three different magmatic intrusions occurred just southwest of the geothermal power plant at between 3 and 4 kilometers in depth. Thus, since 2020, a total of six magmatic intrusions on the peninsula have occurred, and only one so far has resulted in a volcanic eruption. Ignoring the odds an eruption will or will not occur, let's suppose that a brand new volcanic eruption did occur. Where would the lava flow and what would it look like? Near Grindavik, we have two post-Ice Age era lava flows which provide approximations of what the eruption would be like and where would flow. These eruptions both occurred to the northwest in 400 BC and 1240 AD. Both eruptions had an explosive component to them, rating the volcanic explosivity index between a 1 and a 2. If a repeat event of similar intensity were to occur today, the nearby city of Grindavik could expect to see anywhere between a dusting to 4 centimeters in total ashfall. The 400 BC eruption was the more explosive of the group, resulting in a lava flow which expanded in all directions but generally flowed towards the south and southwest. A better comparison to the current situation is the 1240 AD eruption, where several spatter cones erupted close to where the ongoing uplift is, sending lava towards a natural low point between two higher rock edifices. Taking this into account and overlying the current topography of the region, a new eruption will be most likely to send lava flows in two directions as labeled on screen. The area to the north of Grindavik has a bowl-shaped area, so any new lava would pool for an extended length of time before heading towards the town. This pathway could be easily blocked via an earthen dam if an eruption were to occur. The main lava flow would, however, move to the west before turning south. Due to the general flat terrain of the area, such a lava flow might expand and take out several structures on the southwest edge of Grindavik. Of course, everything just said is hypothetical, and we do not know if an eruption will occur. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new Patreon Southtown Slingers for supporting this channel.